This is where the single-engine plane ended up crashing, upside down. Take a look at the damage. It's hard to believe that the 71-year-old pilot was able to climb out of the cockpit himself. He was lying beside the plane when EMTs arrived.
Essentially knew it was going to crash because it was so low.
Mark Bernard and his wife saw this plane falling as they were out for a drive Sunday. They couldn't hear the engine and followed the plane, finding it crashed in the Verso woodyard.
I couldn't see whether he was out or not. It wasn't on fire or anything like that, which was good. So I just went and got my wife to just to make sure what I thought I saw. And then we called 911.
Emergency crews arrived quickly. Police say the pilot, 71-year-old Dr. Gary Cole, was lying beside the plane.
I think we were all kind of wondering how he got out of the plane and didn't have to be extricated by the medical personnel, but clearly he had some serious injuries.
The chief says Cole was conscious but didn't say what happened. Cole is an experienced pilot and was coming from the direction of his neighborhood, Soaring Heights, an aviation community across the street. The plane hit stacked logs, even embedding a piece of a wheel in one of them. The vintage plane flipped and landed here. Dr. Cole is an optometrist with his own practice in Conway. Those who know him say he's been flying for more than 30 years and owns several planes. This was one of his showpieces.
It was in top mechanical condition. He wouldn't take it out or fly it unless it was spot on.
The FAA looked at the plane Monday morning, but so far no word on what caused the crash. And people in this area are used to planes flying overhead, but say this was a shock.
You don't expect that. So, and when something like that happens, naturally you think the worst, hope for the best. And in this case, that's how it turned out.
The plane will stay here at the woodyard until a salvage company can come in and take it away, and then it will be looked at a little bit closer to determine exactly what happened. It could be up to a year before a determination is made. Reporting in Freedom, Heather Hamill, WMUR News 9.